Weight Watchers is slimming down, going through a brand overhaul. The well-known weight loss management company will now be called WW. Now, that doesn't actually stand for Weight Watchers. For reaction to this move, we're now joined by Tony Chapman, CEO of TonyChapmanReactions.com. Good to see you again, Tony.
Good to be here.
So, Weight Watchers rebranding, what's the risk? This is a very well-known brand, and I think when people hear Weight Watchers, they know what they're getting. Do they know what they're getting with WW?
Not at all. So, you say, what's the risk and the reward? Obviously, the risk is they throw away all that equity. So, why would they do that? I think they did it because the whole stigma around weight and weight loss, we're moving away from it. In fact, it's painting a negative stain on their brand. And what they want to do with WW is attach words like wellness that works. And when you have wellness versus weight loss, you now suddenly expand your platform. You can go after the male and female consumer. You can get involved in supplements and spas and hotels. You can go anywhere with it because wellness is not just about weight loss. It's about how you live your life.
I've been noticing a lot more articles lately in terms of people saying exactly what you said, that we're looking at 20, 30, 40 years of approaches to weight and healthfulness, and we've been wrong pretty much on all of it. And they're starting to rethink it. So while it is risky, was it equally as risky to just cling to that old Weight Watchers brand and hope that the new way of thinking didn't sink your company eventually anyway?
Well, yeah, by 2015, this company was on life support. It was losing subscribers. Apps like Fitbit were coming along, taking away their business. Oprah weighs in and says, I'll give you $40 million and I'll also lend you my brand, and turned it around, and her $40 million turned into be worth about $400 million by last May. Massive turnaround, but it was really an artificial one. It was just the power of Oprah. But when you look behind it, the concept of things like a moment on your lips is a lifetime in your hips, just dated itself. Yeah. So I think what Oprah did, sitting on the board, seeing what she did with Dr. Oz, what she did with Dr. Phil, saying, you know what, thought leadership, we got to go beyond just losing pounds. And I think she was a driving force. So was Mindy Grossman. They had a Canadian, Stacey Mowbray, come in and run the Americas. And the three of them came together and said, let's get into this relationship we have with the consumer and say there's so much more we can do. I mean, now they can get into prenatal health. They can get into aging health. They can get into running rooms. They can get into spas. There's a lot you can do with it. And people say, what's WW? You got to remember, more often than not now, your advertising billboard's the screen on your phone. So you got to compress it. The Weight Watchers would have taken over the whole phone.
I could picture it in a little app on your phone, and that would just be the icon.
Yeah, just the icon now is the WW, yeah. And they can attach it to running shoes, athletic socks on Instagram, supplements. And so it's a very smart future focus. Absolutely, the risk is they lose a lot of equity, but I think the sum of the equity they're shedding was bad baggage.
Do they have much of a moat competitively when we think about this? Because there's so many other players. I mean, you mentioned Fitbit. I'm wearing a Fitbit right now. A lot of people jumped into that wellness space. Now Weight Watchers are saying, well, this is what we're about as well.
Yeah, it is. It's very, very few barriers to entry. The only thing they really have going for them is Oprah. So Oprah can attract a lot of talent. Oprah's got her own publishing empire, her voice. She's willing to go publicly on television and say, I feel healthier, my skin feels better, my hair is better, I've lost weight. All the things that you want to attach as hope and benefit and desired outcome. She's probably one of the best spokespeople for it, but she can also bring in her Dr. Oz and Dr. Phil and whoever else is in that within her Rolodex and say, come join the family. When you turn $40 million into $400 million in 3 years, that's an easy way to entice some celebrities, even the Cindy Crawfords of the world, to say, hey, bring your skincare line in. We can help you manage it. So is there any competitive immunity in the space? Zero. Everybody's after beauty. Everybody's after the fountain of youth. But I tell you, I would bet on an Oprah over almost anybody else as my spokesperson.
Yeah, we'll start a company called Ponce de Leon.
I love it.
Always good to have you here, Tony.
Thanks.
I was Tony Chapman, the CEO of TonyChapmanReactions.com.